Hello and welcome to On the Move. The Center for Clinical and Basic Research about Parkinson's disease is located in Sunnyvale, California. As leaders in the study of movement disorders, they have developed strategies that are leading to the discovery of ways to treat and prevent Parkinson's disease. The doctors and staff are engaged in clinical stem cell research to study the disease mechanisms of Parkinson's. Now here is our On the Move host, Donna Yeager.
Hi, I'm Donna Yeager with On the Move, and I'd like to welcome our very special guests, Frank Kellers, Maria Chavez, and Birgitt Schuele.
Hi, Donna.
I'd like to ask Frank, how many years have you actually had Parkinson's?
Well, I think I've had it quite a while, but I wasn't finally diagnosed until I went to the Parkinson's Institute about 3.5 years ago, and I saw one of their movement specialists, and he said there wasn't any doubt that I had Parkinson's, and that's when they started treating me.
And Maria, what is your official title there?
I'm the development manager for the Parkinson's Institute, and I handle outreach, patient relations, donor relations, event planning.
And Birgitt, what is your official title?
My official title is assistant professor. I am a medical doctor, and I do research at the Parkinson's Institute. Okay. And one of the projects that we are doing and the programs is stem cell biology. And we try to find disease mechanisms for Parkinson's disease.
Dr. Langston is the founder, right?
Mm-hmm, that's right. Okay. He founded the Institute, I think, in 1988, okay, about 20 years ago. Yeah. And in 1983, he discovered a drug that was taken by heroin addicts. Mm-hmm. And actually, when these people took this drug, they would get symptoms like Parkinson's patients.
Wow.
And at that time, he started treating these patients with L-DOPA. That's the mm-hmm. also the Parkinson's drug that a lot of the patients take, and they got better. Mm-hmm. And that drug is called MPTP, and that was a really interesting and exciting time. And they developed a lot of animal models with MPTP that could really show the disease in kind of in vivo system.
Very complicated, my goodness. But Frank, you've actually been involved with some of the clinical testing, right?
Yes, I have.
Okay.
It's I was on a test for about 2 years. Yeah. It turns out that I had the placebo, so I didn't. I wasn't taking the medicine, but when they finished the test, well, then I'm taking all the medicine now.
Oh, good, good, yeah. So, Maria, tell us a little more about the actual institute. It's interesting because it not only has a clinic, but it has the doctors there, as well as doing the research at the same time.
Yeah, it's a very unique organization. It's actually the only institute of its kind for Parkinson's disease in the country.
Yeah,
we are very unusual that we're a independent nonprofit that is doing both clinical research, which is all the studies involving people like Frank or any of our studies involving actual patients.
Right.
We have basic research such as Dr. Schuele is doing, looking into the causes of the disease, trying to find compounds that could potentially be a cure or help with treatment. But side by side with that, we actually have a patient care center where we have 6 on-site neurologists who are all movement disorder specialists who see patients. And we see about 3,000 patients a year, which allows us to have a really we offer full service of care there, a continuum of care where we have our doctors working side by side with physical therapists, speech therapists, and also an on-site social worker, you know, a dance instructor, so that we can really try to look at Parkinson's disease, not just in a research setting, but see all aspects of helping the patients and helping patients who have it now.
Mm-hmm. Exactly, yeah.
And we have a choir as well.
Oh, yeah. We even have a choir. Our speech therapist, to help folks who have graduated from our speech therapy program, has started a choir that meets once a month.
Oh, cool.
And it helps them practice and exercise their newfound skills for speaking,
right,
since that's a real problem with Parkinson's disease,
exactly,
is losing your voice. But with the right techniques, you can get back a lot of that.
Mm-hmm.
And Frank here actually is one of the graduates of that program, and
that's
it got huge improvements.
Mm-hmm.
Very,
so,
very important program. And
right,
once we graduate from the program, we have to exercise every day,
right,
our voices, and
right, yeah,
keeps our throats limber so that I don't have swallowing problems.
And exactly.
Pills getting caught in my throat.
So you don't choke, right? Yeah.
It's exactly. Wonderful.
But it is. Isn't it a family involvement very important too?
That's true. Absolutely. Yeah. I think, you know, when we are talking about Parkinson's disease, we have our patients, but their families, you know, this is something that is going to affect everybody in their families. It's something that we're always very concerned with the caregiver, caregiver support. We've recently added our social worker, who is also a trained therapist, has added a class where he's actually taking caregivers and teaching them how to deal with the stress of being a caregiver, especially as the disease progresses for some patients, where they need a lot of caregiver support and they don't understand how to deal with those stresses, techniques, even physical therapy techniques for the caregiver, for how to correctly lift somebody up so you're not straining your back or your shoulder, or deep breathing techniques so that you can learn your patience when you're dealing with your family member. Everybody's Parkinson's is different,
right?
And your Parkinson's is going to change from day to day. It's an evolving condition, and it changes a little bit as your brain chemistry changes. So something that could be working one day may not be working as well the next day. It's a pretty delicate balance when you're looking at brain chemistry, which is why we think it's very important for patients to be under the care of absolutely a neurologist, and if you have one in your area, a movement disorder specialist, which is somebody who is a neurologist that, you know, did additional training to understand these movement disorders like Parkinson's disease.
Birgitt, let me ask you about the spit kit.
This is a collaboration with a company that's called 23andMe. And so what they do with this DNA from the spit kit, they run 650,000 genome markers.
Wow.
That kind of
really
represent the blueprint of each individual cell of you. And there are certain markers, like for diabetes or something, hair color or other interesting things that you would like to know about it. And when you sign up with them, you can, once the test is done, look on their website and kind of search online about your genetic profile, which
that's amazing.
Frank will be doing. And there's one marker that also can tell you a little bit about your risk for Parkinson's disease.
Okay.
And that's where the collaboration comes into play.
Right, right. Mm-hmm. Thank you again so very much.
Thank you, Donna.
Thank you very much. Thank you for having us.
Thank you. And thank you so very much for joining us. Until next time, I'm Donna Yeager with On the Move. Have a wonderful day.